times in life, people, they have come to God, or they are coming to God, they have no pattern, they have no vision, and they are asking God to multiply. God will not multiply what you don't have. You should have something that God can multiply. Is that okay? The anointing of Christ is to multiply what you have. If you don't have anything, even if we multiply it by 10, 10 times 0 is still going to be 0. I said 20 times 0 is still 0. Come on. It doesn't matter how many digits I put the other side. But if I multiply it by 0, it still comes 0. John chapter 6. Jesus. He was talking to the people. 5,000 capacity by the Lake of Galilee. And as he was speaking to them in the late evening, they were all hungry. And Bible says the disciples, they went to Jesus. They said, these people, they are hungry. They need bread to eat. And Jesus looked on his disciples and says to them, you are leaders. What do you have to give to the people? No, so Jesus was saying to them, my leaders, you are responsible to solve the problem. I have been preaching the rest of the day, but you are telling me that your people that you are leading, they are hungry. Do something to them. Until one boy said of his disciples, there is a boy who is walking behind the crowd. He had 5 loaves of bread and he had 2 fish. And Jesus said, bring that guy down here. And Jesus multiplied because there was a pattern and there was a vision. What are you saying, Prophet Mangari? God wants to multiply what you have. If you don't have anything, it's too hard for multiplication to take place. That's why in Hosea the Bible says, my people die because of lack of vision. Is that okay? Habakkuk chapter 2 says, the vision is for the appointment time. And where there is a vision, in Genesis chapter 22, there is a provision. So if you don't have a vision right now, it's going to be hard for the multiplication to take place in your life. If you want God to multiply to give you more cars, at least you should have one car. And then we can multiply it by 2 or add it by 3, then you have more cars. Am I talking to somebody right there? So you should have a proposal before God. As if this is my proposal, and God do something about my proposal. God will act into your proposal. I'm hearing God today. There is an open heaven for some guys here. Your proposal is about to be accessible in heavenly places, and God is about to accredit yourself right now. If you hear me shout, I hear you.